Please get ready for a dictation of transcription number 114 from Sir Kailash Chandra magazine. 5 seconds. Start. We agree in principle with the underlying idea of this resolution that there should be ceiling put on the income to begin with of the civil servants. This class of civil servants has been created by the erstwhile rulers of India, the British imperialists. They have created this class as slave drivers, jobbers and mistresses of this great industrial concern that they were running the government of India after freedom, more particularly today when we are thinking in terms of planning, when we are thinking in terms of closing the gap between the high and the low income in this country, when we are thinking in terms of raising the living standards of the common people, we have got to think in terms of even slashing the highest salaries that have been awarded to this class of people, to this class of civil servants by the earlier rulers of this country. As trade unionists, we have very bitter feelings. My friend Professor Kishan Chand has just now said that there should be ceiling even on industrial income, even on payment of salaries to the managers and the managing staff of private concerns and commercial and industrial concerns. I entirely agree with that proposition. As trade unionists, when we present a case for wage increases, we have been shouting in every place, in every industry, that every concern wants to give higher salaries to the managerial staff in order that they may get the incentive to curb the workers, in order that they may work upon the workers as slave drivers, as mistresses, etc. I entirely agree with Professor Kishan Chand that even the salaries of such people must be slashed, even they must be asked to receive a lower income. Just as a private industrialist, in the interests of the exploitation, in the interests of curbing down ordinary labor, wants to pay higher salaries to the supervisory staff, to the managerial staff. Similarly, the government of India, the earlier government of India, the British government was paying higher salary to this type of managerial staff of this slave concern. Today, sir, we are thinking in terms of covering up this gap, of shortening this gap, and in such circumstances, it is absolutely necessary that on the one hand, we raise the incomes of the lower income groups, and on the other, slash down the incomes of the higher salaried people. I entirely agree with the proposition that the higher salaried people also may be given social amenities like housing, health services, and so on. But these should be included in their total emoluments, which must not be so high. When the Posts and Telegraphs employees, when the railway employees, when the Government of India employees ask for a new pay commission to be appointed, as the earlier commission was appointed at a period when the salary structure of the country was not certain, when the government itself was not in our hands, but that now the production has increased, that the economy of the country is going up in a particular direction, the leadership of the country wants to take the country in a particular direction, you do not agree. When the Posts and Telegraphs employees, the railway employees, the non-gazetted employees ask for an increase in their salaries, you come out saying that their salaries will not be increased unless they increase further the output and production. In this case, you want to link up production with salary when we are telling you that there is no incentive to the railway employees, to the Posts and Telegraphs employees, to the non-gazetted employees. You do not say anything, but you say that there should be incentive to the ICS officers, the police commissioners, and to all these people in the shape of high salaries. This is your policy. But sir, this policy does not hold good with the declaration of a socialistic pattern in the international organizations, in the ILO, and in other places. You say that there should be equal pay for equal work, but certain categories get a very high salary, while certain others who may not be counted as civil servants, who may not be counted as the collectors, but who put in exactly the same amount or even more of work, are not paid the same amount. For example, the collector is paid a certain amount, but what about the civil surgeon? Is not the civil surgeon equally responsible? Is he not the district medical authority? Even then, look at the disparity between the salaries of the civil surgeon and the collector. This sort of disproportion is there even in the higher services. There is disproportion not only between the higher services and the lower services, but there is disproportion even between the higher services of the different categories among the forest services stopped.